Hey guys, Tyrant here bringing you another 2v2 today. We are on Gel's Kitchen Refinery. I think that's how you pronounce it. I have no idea. One of the new maps. Or well, new as of the Brits release. Anyway, playing for you today, we have mixed US and Brits. Spawning in the north, we have Dirk Diggler, who is sporting Royal Artillery, Vanguard, and Tactical Support. Team up with him will be lurking, playing as US forces, who has Rifle Company, Infantry Company, and Airborne. In the south, we have Vetman and Rooted. Double Austere, Vetman has straight away gone for Spearhead, and Rooted has straight away gone for Encirclement. Not too familiar with the cutoffs on this map. Not sure if Encirclement's really going to pay any dividends. Looks like it would be quite hard to get a cutoff. Looks like this here is the cutoff. Yeah, I don't think Encirclement's going to go too well. Looks like it's going to be too hard to get a cutoff maneuver, so you're not going to be able to use close to pocket too effectively. Honestly. But we'll have to see how it plays out. First couple of engagements going on for this fuel point. Nice flank there by those rifles getting behind the MG42 before it can set up. Constantly dodging its arc of fire here. Vietnam's having trouble. Ooh, an early grenade's there, ticked by lurking. Managed to clear that. Looks like it's going to get cleared twice, and he's going to lose that Grenadier squad as well. That, oh no, maybe not. Nice blocking here from lurking. A fresh Grenadier squad. Taking a lot of damage there, but actually getting some lucky RNG there. I thought retreating across this negative cover road it might have gone down, but it was not the case. Still a couple costly engagements there for Vetman in the early game. On the other side, we have a the internal struggle. MG42 versus Vickers and Garrisons. I think Vickers usually wins this engagement, but it does come down to RNG. Hammer that goddamn line! So a pretty good start here from the Allies. They've got both the fuels under their control. We actually see Rooted going with a no tier 1 strategy. He's gone for two pioneers and now he's going straight with his tier 2 structure and bringing out some Panzer Grenadiers. Interesting strategy. It does seem to be costing him a bit of early game control here. And, we do see that Lurking has gone for Rifle Company, so that means most of his riflemen are going to be vetted up. So, even going for a flamethrower half track, it's not going to be that good because most of those riflemen are going to have access to AT grenades. So, that is usually the go-to when you see this structure, and Rouge does have enough munitions to upgrade that. There's a bit of chat going on there. Vickers versus MG42. This is a close one. Looks like the Vickers is pulling ahead now, maybe. Yep. Vickers does win out the day. Oh no, I thought it just died as it was jumping out of the garrison there. Not the case. And Lurking had to retreat all of these rifles at the same time, so he's lost all of the map control on that side of the map. So Allies, after a strong start, faltering in their map control right now. What do we see? Okay, that's why, because Lurking did go for the captain instead of lieutenant, so no 20. I think that's a bit of a mistake, honestly. Need to keep that M20 out, keep that pressure on. Captain Stewart's, it's alright still though, I suppose. And you are going to go to Captain at some point because you're going to get that pack out to... So it's, I mean, it's not measurably worse, it's just I think it's ever so slightly worse. So nice work here from Lurkin using the line of sight blocker of this building, now popping some smoke, trying to close in on that MG. This can be a really hard building to assault, so windows out of every side, or I suppose you're standing on the roof, so I don't know if that counts as windows, but either way. And this is a very comprehensive assault coming from every side. MG's desperately trying to reposition, trying to get it. Good arc on all of these rifles. Down goes that green squad though. Grenade. And it's going to be a mass retreat there on this side. So really nice flank there from Lurking. Comprehensive. We see a sniper now from Dirk Diglett. And we see Rooted using sprint on those P-Goons, trying to get close, trying to get that action going on, also dropping some stormtroopers. Sniper's going down quick, sniper goes down there. Nicely done there by Rooted, getting that pick up on the sniper. Now he's going to clear the 6-pounder as well. And wow, that was just so nice. Sniper and 6-pounder, that is a huge blow to Dirk Diggler.
The sector has been cut off.
People forget, you know, you forget about that sprint. Can be very useful in engagements. We've seen in previous replays Rooted making good use of that. Stormtroopers here waiting in camouflage, hoping to get an ambush on. But these Royal Engineers are not to be trifled with. They're what are they called? Anyway, the SMGs, it's escaping me right now. Stens, that's right. These Stens, very powerful in close range. Got them just before that upgrade popped on the Stormtroopers as well. Unlucky timing there for Rooted.
Units can now use Pierd launchers to take on armor, and Bren guns for extra firepower.
I feel like this map is kind of good for Brits in some ways, because you can go for a universal carrier early and you can retreat it to these bays for those early repairs if it takes a Faust, for instance. Yeah, generally I just don't like this map. It seems a bit convoluted, you know, there are all these shop blockers everywhere on this map, and it's just really just like a bit of a mess in the center, honestly. Too many of these pipes as well, just roaming around, like blocking you from maneuvering. Not really a fan, honestly. So there's another squad of stormtroopers there for Rooted. Interesting choice.
Our opponents are seizing a sector.
Still has a lot of trouble though dealing with this rifle flamer blob. Pretty powerful. 2 stars of vet on 2 of those riflemen. They're all very low on health though. I hope he's got an ambulance, but he doesn't. Well, he does. Where is it? Moving up. Doesn't have the major unlocked yet though, so let's stop there for some forward healing and reinforcements. Looks like he's going to soft retreat back to it. But as I was saying, you know, these pipes being, it's blocking his way back home. Yeah. Causing him to take a rather unusual route. Oh, Stormtrooper's taking a nasty volley of flames there. Probably best to stay in the open in that case rather than taking cover behind that wood. Taking that bonus damage from the flamethrower. Ooh, a Bofa's up here for Diggler. Interesting choice. Let's get to work. I haven't seen one of these in a while. I suppose this is going to be his hard line. He's not going to be pushed back any further than this. And certainly the Allies doing quite well for map control right now. Axis down to just 294 VPs. Haven't had very good VP control at all. Seems like Vietman's really struggling. Lurking's putting on some really good pressure here. Vietman has managed to get his way to P4. He skips tier 2. Try and speed that up a bit quicker. We'll have to see how that gets on. Should be good against Stuart. Stuart does, of course, have a shell shock though, so can escape to safety. And a lot of vetted up riflemen, so lots of AT grenades available for lurking as well. P4's coming around the site. Decent reaction time there from lurking. He's activating shell shock now, otherwise he's dead. Oh, too late. Too late on the draw on the shell shock, and down goes the Stuart. But whilst that's going on, looks like this green squad, ooh, around the corner, may get away to safety. Rifleman trying to chase. Does get to safety. A lot of corpses here. This has been a crazy engagement, and here comes a huge storm of assault troops from rooted from the side. Even in this heavy covered garrison, they're taking so much damage, having to get the hell out of there. Looks like Rouge is going to continue the push. Oh, that's Telamine, I was going to say. Okay, they're safe. Oh, he's going to catch the ambulance here. Oh, huge. He's going deep with this. Picks up the ambulance, may pick up the squad with the Vickers upgrade as well. Oh, don't go any further. Does not manage to get that Vickers squad. Disengages, already up to Vet 1 though, 6 kills. Gonna take down this fuel munitions cache, in fact. So the Axis were a bit on the ropes there, but picking up that Stuart ambulance, they're back in this game now. Some nice coordination there by the Axis as well. Good timing on that push. The P4 combined with all those assault troops coming from the side, it caused all sorts of issues for the Allies.
Heavy truck, ready for orders.
But the Axis need a machine gun over here if they're going to try hold on to all this newly gained territory. Even then though, you got to worry about those rifle flamethrowers if you're going to try put your machine gun in a garrison, and of course they have smoke as well, so it's tough to beat these rifle flame blobs. But sometimes you have to blob harder. We see a massive force of grenadiers here, supported by a Stug now. We know Richard's very fond of the Stug. Needs to go to them on most of his matches, and does have very good rate of fire. I feel like it was maybe better against Brits in the last patch. It was really good against the Crocodile. It seems like we don't see the Crocodile as often these days. Just Churchill's in general, more in favour of the Comets. Which I feel like the Stooks, while they perform okay against, they still do bounce against the Comets. Strong frontal armour quite frequently. And the Comets guaranteed to penetrate the Stug every time, so I feel like maybe they're not quite as effective. And in general, if you're going double Ostia, probably suggest one player just tick straight to tier 4, as we seen one of my other casts, one of the teams going for an early Panzer weapon. Making use of your strong AT in the form of packs, and that strong indirect fire in the form of the Panzerwerfer, and then later on going for the Panthers, which can really duke it out against the Comets. So a bit of Brit artillery being called in here from one of his forward observer squads. Boy 2 doing some nice work though, suppressing all those troops. Assault continues. Don't see. Okay, 6-pounder. And is that a firefly in the background from Dirk Deagland? Interesting choice. Oh, what was that? Was Royal Artillery shell actually connects and does some damage. That's a rare sight. Vietnam definitely needs to reposition his MG42. He's been sitting behind the smoke. He hasn't bothered to reposition that for a long time. He's taking a lot of damage from this bazooka. Oh, don't lose your P4 for no good reason here. Finally, the smoke wears out. Now these two Vickers squads have got on its flank, and that's going to be a full retreat here for the Allies. I mean, for the Axis. And they're going to maybe perhaps lose this stolen six-pounder. No, okay, Rooted has managed to bring over a second MG42 to try and support. So some nice teamwork here from the Axis, getting some good maneuvering going on. I feel like probably that Firefly needed to join in on that fight if they were to hope to win that. And they probably could have got killed that P4 in that case. And honestly, I think Firefly is a kind of mistake in some respects, but kind of not in the other. It could easily burst down these Stugs in one volley. And because they're assault guns, they're less maneuverable than a P4, so you're more likely to get the Tulip Rocket skill shot going. So maybe that's his plan. Does have a Comet Bulletin as well. I think I did read somewhere that this tank commander is actually bugged. It says that squad will gain variancy fast. I believe I read somewhere on, I think it was on code2.org, that it actually gives your opponents less variancy when they shoot at it. So, I mean, it's still good, but it's not what it claims to be. Maybe that could be incorrect as well. It's hard to know, you know. It's hard to know these things, hard to test them out easily in game.
We are losing a sector.
So a pretty formidable medium tank army here for the Axis. Two Stugs and a P4. Oh, and that's an interesting choice. Dirk Diggler's also decided to fit some Piats onto his infantry section. But that's actually not a bad idea against Stugs. They do have to be rather less mobile to shoot than their turreted counterparts, so maybe you're going to have a better chance of landing one of those Piat shots. And when Piats land, they are good. They are very strong.
Bofors crew ready.
So, Axis really in trouble in terms of VPs. Down there, we're just 1-16. They seem to be winning the last few engagements, though. And have squeaked out an army size advantage. Of course, that's slightly skewed by the fact that Lurking is repairing his tank right now. But still, they have squeaked out a small army size advantage. And this is actually quite interesting. I think the... These stormtroopers are actually quite good on this map. There's lots of like cheeky spots where they can cover, use their camouflage, and then just ambush squads as they run through these tight avenues. I mean, just look at all this light cover they can ambush from behind. So I think stormtroopers are actually quite effective on this map. Whoa, look at this. This is a formidable army here. A vet man, look at this. How many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 grenadiers. My god. Still hasn't back-ticked, though. Still hasn't back-ticked, and I think that's a mistake. They probably need another AT gun. They've only got one, and that's that stolen six-pounder on this side of the map. That is, there's a pack holding down this side. Tactical advance, I think slightly backfiring here for Rooted. Honestly, I'd suggest trying to get a little bit closer before activating it.
sector.
And he was focusing this squad. I think this squad was a little bit closer. Important, every little thing like that counts.
Armor ready to move.
So Dirk Diggler deciding to go for a Cromwell here. I don't know why. Probably would have ticked a hammer myself and gone for a Comet. Would have had enough fuel to do that. Oh, and there's the Panzerwerfer. That's what we're talking about. We just haven't ticked up. But be careful though, those tanks can just roll through one of these walls and ambush your Hendrik fire choice very easily. In fact, that looks like Lurking is trying to execute that exact thing, and he's going to run straight into it here. Oh my god. Oh, poor Rooted. He even tried to move away from it. You know, he did the brush from over here and he tried to back to safety a little bit, but he didn't back far enough and ends up losing his Panzerwerfer. Costly loss there. Stug's in hot pursuit though, but he doesn't have any way of immobilizing this tank. Doesn't have any telemines that I'm aware of. Got a lot of munitions though, probably should have put some down. So this EZH is pretty safe. Stug's opening up on the EZ-8, doing a lot of damage to it, but as I was saying, with no engine damage, I think it's going to get away to safety. Ooh, whoa, maybe not. Stug's in hot pursuit, they are on the road, they've got superior movement speed here. Don't manage to get a shot off there.
Pour it on. Crowd's down to 100 points.
Oh no, EZ-8 ends up shooting, may have revealed itself. No! Manages to back to safety, I guess this is also a road. Speeds away to safety. Lucky escape there from that EZ-8 after diving that hard. Managed to get away to safety.
We're losing a capture point.
Still Rooted did manage to avoid losing that pack, so could have been a lot worse. Yeah, like this is a point in time though where Rooted needs to get some Talamines down. He's got quite a few squads of Pioneers. Some Talamines down, that would be excellent. I know that allies are being quite diligent with their minesweeping, but when you've got 400 munitions in the bank, you've gotta start making use of it. Oops, sorry. Elbowed the mic there. So Axis have managed to steady the ship now, after getting off to a shaky start. Holding on to two VPs, but it looks like the Allies about to make an assault through the center. His mines though, almost, or does in fact pick up with a wipe on that squad. His mines are so nasty. I mean, some players complain about them having the signs, but imagine if they didn't. These things are like insta-wipe mines, like they're so crazy. And you don't have to plant the whole field. Rearm exposed here for these P4s. Almost getting a couple shots off. In fact, these P4s are in a bit of trouble here, especially if that Firefly was still around, but that's on the wrong side of the map actually, so it's not going to happen. So now just back away for some repairs. Notice only one squad of Pioneers for Vidman, and he's got a Tiger now as well. He needs more Pioneers. You need at least two, probably three would be preferable when you've got an armored force this large. Otherwise he's just going to have the amount of commission for so long trying to repair them up with just one lone Pioneer squad. Doesn't even have any veterans either. Make things worse. Looks like Rooted managed to clear a 6-pounder there and destroy it with the Stugs. Tiger roaring through the center of the map. Stormtroopers coming in from the side. What's that? That's a second Cromwell. This is. Why are you making? I mean, Cromwells are very good, but if you can, just get the Comet. So good. Of course we do see, oh look at that crush, nice! There's one good feature of the Cromwell. Oh, and then comes the artillery cover. Whoa, look at this. White phosphorus comes down as well. All these squads so low. Turret disabled on the Tiger. It's in trouble. Strug's coming in from the side here, trying to join in all, but the EZA takes engine damage from a friendly shot there, I think. But there's the artillery cover smoke. It automatically smokes low health vehicles. Down goes the Tiger. Both these Strugs powerless at this point. He's stuck in the smoke. Main guns keep getting disabled. This is the power of the artillery cover right here. Both these Strugs gonna go down now. Yep. Probably gonna lose these AT guns as well. There you see, this is the artillery cover. As you can see it, it's just so overpowered right now. If you see this white ring, just get the hell out of there. That's my advice. Just way too strong invulnerability. Kind of flew under the radar in the last few patches, though. It's always been this powerful, just because the crocodile was so OP. Now that's not the case. People are free to experiment with the artillery cover. I actually found out about it because of a 4v4 I played, and somebody used it with great effect. White phosphorus being brought in, just forcing all those grenadiers to retreat, and going to be healing up for a very long time. That's four squads on very low health now. Those medics are going to have their work cut out for them, that's for sure. Ooh, that's interesting. I didn't realize that those repair bays are actually not going to repair your tank if you decrew it. That's something to keep in mind there for your US forces players. I'm not sure what is faster, whether the repair crew or the repair bay is faster. Ooh, what's that? A couple Brens on the ground there. Did I miss some infantry sections dying? Maybe not. As I said earlier, sometimes they do drop their guns, even if they've only got one weapon, when they get to two men. I've noticed that in my own matches. So now Rooted has transitioned into Panthers. I think this is the right choice. Oh, EZX diving for the Panther. Oh no, what's this? It's another white phosphorus barrage, and that's going to be a mass retreat there. Rooted.
RE Sappers reporting in.
Looks like we've got a fresh Tiger now from Vietman. Roaring through the center of the map. Allies do start to cap this though, so Axis in real trouble in terms of VPs now. All their infantry keeps getting forced back by healing, and now they're both just all banking on this one heal bay. Really, I think they need two at this point, especially when facing off against this white phosphorus, stream of white phosphorus. Looks like the Allies going to try to get this triple cap running and maybe successful, but here comes a massive armored force from the Axis. Out with all these riflemen. Oh, in comes the artillery cover again. So, as I was saying, when you see this, get the hell out. Oh my god, and you keep. I'm not sure how it works. Maybe if you get the main gun disable crit, and then you get a follow-up shot that also gets engine damage. Not sure entirely how the engine damage part of that works. But the Axis perhaps learning their lesson after that first engagement, just backing out of that circle as soon as they can. EZA tries to follow up, tries to get the kill on that P4, but unsuccessful. Aruta has managed to push through in the center, and the green blob pushed out to the left. So Drain is going to stop shortly, but the Axis down just 35 VPs there, in a tough spot now. We have a quite a formidable army, but so do the allies. How many Cromwells do we have here? Okay, two Cromwells and a Firefly, four infantry sections and those salvage engineers. I don't know if there are any tank wrecks on the field. There was a Tiger. Doesn't really matter that much, honestly. Gammon Bomb goes in on that machine gun. Firefly's in a bit of trouble here. Tiger's roaring straight forwards. Needed the Panthers in support though. Panthers just appearing up on the road. Those Panthers ran down the road here. I think they could have picked up that Firefly. Packhouser are being brought in. Try and cap. Run some Vet 3 pea greens though. They quickly clear it. Wow. Some people, you know, underestimate the Panzer Grenadiers, but they seem to be casting quite a few games, but they're doing quite well against British. Do have that reduced reinforcement cost these days, remember? Tiger's in trouble. Easy 8's diving it. Oh, the Easy 8 goes down. And luckily, they get an extra shot on it, because I think it might have got another shot before. Died in that death crit. Oh, and down goes the Firefly as well. Good pickups there from the Axis. The allies now seem to be on the ropes. Lurking's got a just incredibly small army now. Lost so many easy eights. And these Cromwells just they're gonna have trouble with the Panthers. This is where I feel like if he had some comets instead, he could have had a similar amount of comets, the allies would be in a much better position. Now I feel like the allies are just going to try to rely on artillery cover, make a push and try drain those last 34 VPs in some fashion. Ooh, engagement going on for the left. A lot of infantry sections bursting off against a lot of grenadiers. With the 5-man squads, and Vickers probably going to win this engagement. You now have a new and that's a panic retreat there from Vetman. Really, this artillery that these infantry sixes calls in is, I mean, it's very weak. So nothing to cause a retreat, as we can see. Dirk Diggler has no qualms about just running into the firing line himself. So yeah, don't retreat to that artillery. So. Jump out of a garrison if they're doing it on a garrison, but otherwise just soak it up. It's only going to do a very light amount of damage. As you can see, like a shell lands right here, doesn't even cause this guy to flinch. Well, this is a very formidable armored force here for Vetman. Got three P4s and a Tiger, got two Panthers and a Stuk were rooted, so the Axis definitely having the superior armored force here. And a nice work there from Rooted, sprinting in, trying to prevent any VPs being drained whatsoever. Looks like the allies are starting to move the armor over this side now, so we may be in for a big armored duel. And personally, I look forward to it. Here we go. No. Jackson not on prioritized vehicles. Actually, just shooting at these stormtroopers. Oh, whoa! That was a lucky shot there from that Easy 8. Wipes that stormtrooper squad. P4's running straight forwards. Oh my god, this is going to be crazy. Panthers coming forwards as well. Oh no, but in comes the artillery cover. This could be just devastating. perfect artillery cover here. Axis just need to push straight through it here, otherwise they're gonna just die. Oh, and look at all these main gun destroyed. The artillery cover is just wrecking shop here. Oh, but as I was saying, don't get too close to it yourself, because it'll damage your own tank's engine if you get caught in the crossfire. Now the Axis just decided to try disengage here. Mistake! You cannot run through artillery cover backwards. Still coming from the side, looks like it's going to pick up the EZ-8. But this is just going horribly wrong for the Axis here. They're going to lose all their tanks. And the Allied tanks, as soon as they get low, they auto-pop smoke and they're backing away to safety. Yes, so I believe that's how it works from watching this game. It looks like if you take a main gun, Chris, and then another one of those shells lands, you'll take engine damage. So if you take the main gun, Chris, just keep moving, otherwise you'll take engine damage. That's a comet now, finally, from Dirk Diggler. I feel like this was long overdue. Comet's going deep for the P4, and P4 with armored skirts actually bounces a comet shot there, and the comet goes down. Wow! Oh my god. Still, I mean, that was a crazy tank engagement there. What did we... I think we saw two P4s go down and a Panther. What did we... went down, I think a Cromwell and a Comet, and a EZ-8 went down with allies. And the Jackson went down as well, in fact. So actually pretty even, but allies definitely should have won that. They are heavily outnumbered, and Axis even brought some AT guns as well. We should have won that much more heartily if it wasn't for the artillery cover and lurking once again, throwing away his tanks. But here comes the Cromwell trying to finish the job on the Tiger. Does manage to do so, but I think he's going to lose his dead to Cromwell now. The allies just need to stop throwing away their tanks here. It's such a good lead, but now they just keep throwing them away. Also need to bring in AT guns to support in these tank engagements. I feel like that's where they're going wrong. As for Axis, down to just 34 VPs, they need to stay very, very aware of what the VP situation is. Maybe start putting down some MG bunkers. I think an MG bunker, you know, in this position facing here would be a good idea. Probably one facing here. Be a good idea. Just spam him out. I think rooted. He's got a lot of munitions spare. He should probably get on top of that. Also close to pop cap, so bunkers costing no population cap. Feel like that's where rooted should go next. Also, Dirk Diggler has managed to burn through all that munitions he had stashed up. So no more artillery cover for a long time. Recon plane now coming in from Vietman, just scouting the terrain. Good choice. It's going to spot all of this from lurking, and of course this big push here from Dirk Diggler. Stormtroopers go down there for rooted, unfortunately, on their retreat path. Ooh, is that fragmentation bombs? Frag bombs behind enemy lines, clear the M1. Not worth it. 180 munitions just to clear an AT gun, which can be reinforced for what? Very cheaply. No real point. If you're going to do it during engagement on the AT guns, so that they either have to reposition or die during engagement. That's when it actually matters, rather than just a tiny bit of bleed. How much is this? 28, so I mean, that's it. but over 100 manpower, I mean, that's really not worth 180 munitions. Nice reaction time there by Rooter, dodging that grenade. Exus making a push, but now there are three AT guns set up here. It's only going to go poorly for them. Kind of surprised that they didn't scout this out with their that recon plane. I'm surprised they didn't realize that there were so many AT guns over here, and that this push is really going to amount to nothing. Oh no, Vet3 stormtroopers! Go down to the comet. So it looks like both sides agreeing to duke it out here over the right VP. Ally's also getting very long VPs now. Close game after such a large lead. I feel like lurking has a fair way to go in terms of tank preservation. He's lost so many easy 8s for no real gain. Lucky that so many shots are bouncing or missing here. Oh my god. Otherwise that would have been another dead easy 8 for sure right there. Duke Diggler does deploy some more salvage engineers. If any tanks to salvage on his side. Looks like both all the wrecks are destroyed, unfortunately. Nice use of a target weak point there. No, not even target weak point, just a lucky tiger shell shocking that comet, and down it goes. So it looks like Rooter has managed to find a flaw in that MG's setup arc, managing to neutralize that VP, which is good because this one's also become neutralized. Allies in a bit of trouble in terms of fuel though, out of fuel now. So they've had to send a squad over here to cap this one. Looks like they prioritized that over the VPs. And now they're going to create a very formidable wall of AT guns. This is where Rooted Nisa maybe get another Panzerwerfer. Oh, and is boarding a bunker. Good choice, good choice. Because look at this, look at how much stuff there is here. That's it. Panzerwerfer heaven, right there. So Panthers here, not being terribly effective. They do have the Pintles upgraded though. The bunker's a little bit too far back. It doesn't cover the entire VP. I think that's a bit of a mistake. Probably would have been better about here. But honestly, it's going to have trouble staying alive anyway, anywhere he puts it, because there's so many AT guns over here. Probably would have been a better choice on one of the other VPs. Oh, Panthers in a bit of trouble here. A lot of AT guns here. A lot of damage. Is the Easy 8 going to dive it? Or has he learned his lesson? No, he hasn't learned his lesson. Runs into a P4. He's getting very tight in the VPs, but Dirk Diggler is very close to another artillery cover. So, that could be devastating with this many AT guns. If all these tanks take engine damage, they could just be sitting ducks. This is where you need to have that frag bombs saved up. So if they drop that, then you can drop the frag bombs on the AT guns. Luckily, Bitman does have enough munitions. Oh no, is he going to drop that? No, no. Okay, they're dropping artillery cover. Here we go. This is where you need to back off. Not charge right in. Okay, this is going to go terribly wrong. Oh my god. Everything's getting pinned by the artillery cover. Just tanks getting wrecked. And that's going to be a mass retreat, I think. Yeah, if you see your opponent pop it, just back away. Try focus on the other two VPs. As it is, Axis in trouble here. They're going to lose control of this left-hand VP. Didn't have a machine gun or a bunker over here. Big mistake. No tank over there to help, really. This is where you need P4 to run over to this side. And accordingly, I think they're going to maybe lose the game here. They're getting very low on VPs. Panther sent him with breakthrough. Nice execution there from Rooted. Manages to neutralize that, stop the drain. Panther's in a bit of trouble here though. Cromwell and EZ8 going deep. Having trouble penetrating. It's a tough front alarm though, and there is the 6-pounder there for support. Cromwell's going deep though. EZ8 pops smoke, but I think that's only served to hurt him. And looks like the Panther's gonna go. This Cromwell's gonna go down after diving that Panther. Allies seem to be so reckless with their tanks, they're just continuously diving time and time again for no benefit. As for Vietman, needs to get that blob over to that left hand VP. Root is desperately trying to hold on to the center VP. Does have that MG bunker there, but as I was saying, slightly incorrect positioning on it. Not helping the cause, and this is going to be the end here. Axis slow to react to this. Now Rifle getting a flank on this MG. Pop smoke on it as well. Okay, target's deployed over there. Good choice, good decision. Maybe we can use breakthrough again to try and neutralize this. I think that would probably be a good idea. He's got plenty of fuel to spare. Once it cools down, I think that would be a good choice. If they do manage to hold on to that central VP, good. Oh, this is getting so close, down to just 27 VPs. We need to use breakthrough again here, otherwise they're going to lose on VPs. M1 being brought up. Looks like the Panthers are still going to disengage here. That's alright. It's alright, they have managed to wrestle control of these VPs here on the left. Now they just have to hold on to the center, and it looks like that the allies are maybe going to consider pushing over there. Infantry section slowly working their way over. M1 working on the bunker, but going through the fog of war, it is rather inaccurate. Enemy is attacking one of our forward buildings. So I think this is a good decision here from the Axis. Just trying to camp two VPs. Definitely though, they need a Panzerwerfer. I mean, look at this. This is just so juicy. So juicy for a Panzerwerfer. Ooh, this is risky. Vietman going on the offensive here. EZ8 could be in trouble though. Two P4s and a Tiger. Nope, Tiger's misses. Oh, P4's missing as well. Miss. Doesn't matter, they're going to stick around, kill the ambulance, kill the M1. Some nice kills there. Here comes the Cromwell. Oh, this is a close one. This is a really close one. Looks like the Panthers both have been appearing up here by the repair bay. So they're going to return to combat now. Two Cromwells. Marines head on into two Tigers and P4. That could be trouble. Is he going to take engine damage? No, didn't get the Faust off. Looks like they're just probing the line, seeing what's happening. Oh, nicely done there by Bruta, getting down a bunker. As I was suggesting, he's doing good with these bunkers now. He's keeping them in good spots. Just trying to hold the line with his very high population army. He's hot capped. Bitman thinks they're on the ropes. He's going deep. Pushing right the way to their base. Got to be careful though. There is quite a lot of AT here. Oh, but in come the Panthers from the side. Probably need to continue their dive here. Could easily pick up one of these Cromwells. Is that a second ambulance getting killed there? What is the rally point on these ambulances? I don't understand. Looks like Bruce is focusing on wiping that M1 off the face of the earth. Very tight finish here. Looks like the Allies are going to finally react, send some of their AT guns over there. They need those 6 pounders. The M1's not powerful enough. Duke it out against these Axis heavies. Panthers, frontal armor. Oh, Easy Axe about to go down. Oh, but he drops artillery. It should cover his retreat somewhat. Oh, there we go. The first time I've ever seen this artillery actually wipe anything. And 6 pound also goes down to the base MG. So AT guns are worming their way over to the left hand side, and in fact pretty much all the support weapons. So this is where Vetman needs to pop a recon plane. Ooh, nice white phosphorus, and that's going to cause a lot of retreats. Can the Allies do it here? Axis need to send something over here to just probe, see what's over here, because there's nothing here. This is where a recon plane would really come in handy. Okay, it looks like the Allies are going to make a push for the center. In fact, Rutan's using these bunkers for his MG as well as having the MG upgrade on them. Whoa, and did that squad just die? Whoa, do squads die when the bunker dies? My god. Whoa. That is unfortunate. Now he's lost both his, well, he's lost so much. All of a sudden, Rooted's army size dropped from 100 to 60. This Panther's gonna try to hold the line here, but I mean, there's a lot of AT here. There's not much they can do. This is where you need frag bombs. Bruder has activated breakthrough, trying to hold on to this VP, but he's taking a punishing amount of AT fire here. Is going to manage to hold on just. And the Allies go down. Wow, that was a chaotic and a really fun game. Got to see artillery cover. As you see, it's a very, very strong, way overpowered. So get on it, boys. My viewers can now be well aware of how strong artillery cover is. Dirk Diggler, I feel like he should have gone comets earlier. And Allies just overall need to work on their tank preservation, just diving recklessly for no real reason. Threw away a huge lead. As for Vetman, needs to work on his blobbing skills, maybe slightly blob a little bit less. And yeah, that'll do. Really fun game. GG by both, well played by both sides. I'll wrap on that, guys. If you'd like your game to be cast by me, details in the video description below. Otherwise, I'll catch you all for the next thrilling installment. Goodbye and good luck.